dear student, we are in lecture of NEET NCEE chapter solution. Here we are going to discuss some MCQ. So first question is at 50 degrees Celsius temperature. At 50 degrees Celsius temperature, vapor pressure of pure benzene is 268 millimeter height of mercury. In 1 mole benzene, how much mole of solute should be added? So vapor pressure became 160 millimeter height of mercury for same temperature in each tapmane. At 50 degrees Celsius temperature, vapor pressure of pure water, pure benzene, 50 degrees Celsius upar pure benzene no vapor pressure given. Here vapor benzene is our solvent, so 268. In 1 mole benzene, how much mole of solute should be added? So vapor pressure became 160. Degrees 160. This one is vapor pressure of pure solvent. This one is the vapor pressure of a solution. So now mole of this solute we have to define. Mole of this solvent is given. So P degree minus P upon P degree is equal to N2 upon N1 plus N2. So here pure P degree is a pure solvent's vapor pressure minus 160 P degree 286. Here N1 is very less, so negligible, so N2 upon N1, N1 is 1. Here 108 divided by 286, so is equal to N2. So N2 equal to 108 upon 286. So mole of solute should be 0.675 is our answer. Understood? Check yourself up. Sorry, 0.377. Yeah, answer is 0.377 mole. When we dissolve some solute 0.377 mole in 1 mole solvent, so depression in freezing point, decreasing in the vapor pressure 160 occurs. Okay. Now next question, question number second. vapor pressure of 5% weight by weight. Vapor pressure of 5% weight by weight. Aqueous solution means made in water of urea. Vapor pressure of the water, pure water, is given 23.5 millimeter height. Here tell you 5% weight by weight means 5% weight by weight aqueous solution of urea means 5 gram of urea and 95 gram of water is present. So P degree minus P upon P degree, W2 upon M2, W1 here M1, P degree is given 23.5, P we have to define here 23.5, W2 is mass of a solute 5 gram, molecular mass of solute urea is 16, mass of the solvent 95 gram, and molecular mass of the water 18 gram. So here 23.5 minus P upon 23.5, so 18 5 90 divided by 16 and 95 0.01578. So 23.5 minus P 0.01578 into 23.5. So here multiplication 0.0 into 23.5 is 0.37. So pressure, another side it will be plus. So 23.5 minus 0.37. So 23.13 millimeter height is our answer. So our final vapor pressure of the solution is P and derived value is 23.13 millimeter. Badhane dekhai chhe ne barabar. Okay, now come to the next question. A mixture of volatile components A and B volatile components A and B has total vapor pressure in 4P 254 minus 119 XA, where XA is the mole fraction of A mixture. Hence the P degree A and P degree B are yes, two volatile components of our mixture A and B is present. Total pressure is given in the formula form, in the form of in form PT 254 minus 119 XA. XA is small fraction of component A. We have to define pure vapor pressure of component A and vapor pressure of pure component B. This equation, now according to Raoult's law, according to Raoult's law, बता दिया ना जो आपको जो छताई P is equal to P total, yes, P total is equal to P degree A XA plus P degree B XB. Clear? Here in our given equation there is only XA, so we have to convert XB into XA form. We know XA plus XB is equal to 1, so XB will be 1 minus XA. Clear? So here P total will be P degree A XA plus P degree B into 1 minus XA. So P degree A XA plus P degree B minus P degree B XA. So P total will be P degree A, no, P degree B here. Minus P degree B XA plus P degree A XA. Here, which one is common? XA is common. So, P degree B minus P degree A. XA derived common, XA. A minus chel inside bracket, this one plus, so inside it will be minus. So both we have to compare equation 1 and given PT 254 minus 119 XA. Now we have to compare P total, P total. So P degree B na place upar 255 che. So P degree B direct 254 millimeter. Now here we are comparing XA, XA. So now P degree B minus P degree A equal to 119. Ana barabar 119 che. So put the value of P degree B 254 minus P degree A. So here P degree A equal to 254 minus 119. 14 minus 9, so 5. 4 minus 1, 3, so 135 millimeter is the answer. So P degree A and P degree B derived. Next question, an azeotropic mixture of HCl and water is at 1 atmosphere. An azeotropic mixture of HCl and water is at 1 atmosphere. Answer A. 84% of HCl, 22.2% of HCl by mass, 63% of HCl and 20.4% of HCl. Tell me. Listen. Here, this example is not given in our book. In our book, for azeotropic mixture, example of HNO3 is given. 63% HNO3. When we dissolve into water, so it gives azeotropic mixture. But here is about HCl. So answer is D. Azeotropic mixture is one kind of mixture. After mix up both components, we can't separate easily both of from them. That is the azeotropic mixture. In the 20.4% HCl means out of 100 gram, 20.4 gram is HCl, remaining 79.6 gram of water is present there. So which makes a azeotropic mixture? Yes, answer D. But the numericals type not question is necessary nahi. Theoretical question pan hoy che. Yes. Next question, the vapor pressure of a solvent. The vapor pressure of a solvent decreased by 10 millimeter height of mercury when a non-volatile solute was added to the solvent, the mole fraction of a solute in solution is the 0.2. What would be the mole fraction of solvent if the decrease in vapor pressure is the 20 millimeter height? First, read your question once again. Vapor pressure of a solvent decreased by 10 millimeter mercury when a non-volatile solute was added to the solvent, the mole fraction of solute that time is the 0.2. Mole fraction of solid is 0.2. Tyare, decreasing of vapor pressure delta P is the 10 millimeter. What would be the mole fraction of solvent? The decrease in vapor pressure is 20 millimeter. Yes. Now, 10 millimeter, 20 millimeter decrease thai jai. The mole fraction of the solvent, how much? We know P degree according to Raoult's law. Understood? P degree minus P upon P degree is equal to X2. Relative lowering in vapor pressure, Raoult's law is equal to mole fraction of the solute. So here P degree minus P means lowering, not relative lowering. Relative lowering this one only lowering, decreasing in vapor pressure. So X2 into P degree. Yes. Delta P is 10 millimeter. Mole fraction of solute is 0.2 at 10 millimeter decreasing with air and P degree. Yes. Now, in the second case, it is decreases up to 20 millimeter. Same solution decreases vapor pressure 20 millimeter. So X2 we have to derive. P degree will be fixed by a pure solvent chain vapor pressure to fix it. Equation 2 divide by equation 1. So 20 by 10 X2 into P degree upon 0.2 into P degree. P degree cut. So X2 is 0.2 into 2. So 0.4. But this is the mole fraction of a solute chain. But we have to derive mole fraction of solvent. So X1 plus X2 is equal to 1. So 1 minus X2. So 1 minus 0.4. So X1 is 0.6. So mole fraction of the solvent is 0.6. Like 10 degrees in theater mole fraction 0.2 or 20 degree mole fraction of solute 0.4. But solute no nahi, solvent no nahi kuch hai. So 1 minus 0.4, it gives 0.6. Understood? Now, next. When, new question, when 0.004 molarity sodium sulfate is an isotonic with zero point zero one molarity glucose, the degree of dissociation of Na2SO4 will be, yes, here 0.004 molarity solution of Na2SO4 is isotonic. Isotonic means same osmotic pressure with the glucose. The degree of dissociation of Na2SO4 will be now 4 Na2SO4. Pi is equal to I into CRT. Yes, here I we have to define. Molarity 0.004. R constant, T constant. Now for glucose, pi is equal to CRT. 0.01 into RT. We are comparing both equations. So I into 0.0 RT is equal to 0.01 RT cut. So I will be 0.01 upon 0.004. So upward 1104. So value of I is 2.5. Now I need to SO4. Ionide is M gives 2 Na plus and SO4 minus 2. So 1 0 0. 1 minus alpha, 2 alpha alpha. So total mole at equilibrium will be 1 minus alpha, 2 alpha and alpha. Alpha alpha cut. So 1 plus 2 alpha. So I will be total mole upon initial mole. So I is given 2.5. So 1 plus 2 alpha upon 1. So 1 multiply 2, 2.5. So 2 alpha is equal to 2.5 minus 1. So 2 alpha is equal to 1.5. So 1.5 divided by 2, 0.75. So degree of dissociation is 0.75. But percentage of dissociation, 75. A 0.75 100 multiply karo. એટલે ડિગ્રી ઓફ ડિસોસિએશન 0.75 બટ પર્સન્ટેજ ઇઝ 75%. નેક્સ્ટ ક્વેશ્ચન. Elevation in boiling point of a solution elevation in boiling point of a solution will be 13.44 gram of cupric chloride in 1 kilogram of water is added. Molecular mass of cupric chloride is 134.4 gram per mole. Kb for the solution 0.52. Yes, Kelvin per molality. We discuss about it. Yes, this one also true unit term. Elevation in boiling point. Here cupric chloride is electrolyte. So we are assuming here 100% ionization occurs. So I will be 3 for the CuCl2. It gives 3 ions. So delta Tb is equal to I into Kb into M. Here I is 3. Kb 0.52. Molality 1000 into mass of solute, mass of solvent M, mass of solute upon molecular mass of solute and mass of the solvent. So 3 into 0.52 1000 W2 13.44, here 134.4, and W1 1 kilogram, so 1000. So 3 into 0.52 into 0.1, so 0.3 into 0.52, 156, 0.156 in degree Celsius. Yes, elevation in boiling point in Celsius and Kelvin remains same. Boiling point are different in Celsius and Kelvin, but elevation in boiling point remains same in Celsius and in Kelvin. Change remains same. Understood? Now, very simple question asked in JEE. Yes. I am giving you a question during depression in freezing point. This question asked in IIT. During the depression in freezing point in a solution, the following are in equilibrium. During depression freezing point, the pure water no freezing point zero છે. કોઈ સોલ્યુટ એડ કરીએ એટલે ડિપ્રેશન ફ્રીજિંગ પોઈન્ટ આવશે. સો ઇન વિચ વન ઇક્વિલિબ્રિયમ એસ્ટાબ્લિશ ધ લિક્વિડ સોલ્વેન્ટ સોલિડ સોલ્યુટ બી લિક્વિડ સોલ્વન્ટ and liquid solute C, liquid solute and solid solute D, liquid solute and solid solvent in which equilibrium establishes a common according to Raoult's law. Whenever our solvent is a liquid, we are adding some solute which is solid, so freezing point decreases. So here equilibrium established between liquid solvent and solid solute. This question is asked in JEE. Understood? Now I am going to last question of the day. Boiling point of a solution is 383 Kelvin. Boiling point of a solution is 383 Kelvin. So find out freezing point of that solution. Yes, here molality is not given. KB is 0.5 52, suppose Kf is 1.86, and here we have to assume our solute is a non-volatile and a non-electrolyte. So here first, actually boiling point of pure water is 373. Clear? Here boiling point of solution is 383. So elevation in boiling point TB minus T degree B. 383 minus 373. So 10. So elevation in boiling point is 10. And so delta TB is equal to I KB into M. Delta TB can, I is 1, KB 0.52. So we can define molality. So 10 upon 0.52. So I think molality should be something 10 divided by 0.52, 19.23. First molality derived. Then after delta TF, I KF into N. I is 1, KF 1.86 and 19.23. So 1.86 into 19.23, so 37.56. This is not our freezing point. This is depression in freezing point, decreasing in freezing point. But delta TF is equal to, think if TB minus T degree B here, T degree F minus T here. Our freezing point alpha in Kelvin, suppose our water, so 273 change 37.56, so TF we can easily derive. So value of TF, TF comes here 273 minus 37.56. 273 minus 37.56, so 235.44 Kelvin. चलिए आओ पूछाई छे खाली boiling point आयको तो यहाँ से freezing point सुधीन derive थाई. Yes, we will meet in our next lecture with new point, new chapter. Do your work with different kind of reference books, please. Bye.